XFM News. On point. And let's take a look at the news. Uganda AIDS Commission has warned men above 45 years against engaging in reckless lifestyles since they are the most vulnerable to HIV/AIDS. Currently, 14% of men above 40 years are at high risk because most of them have money and tend to seduce young girls into sex or buy prostitutes for sexual pleasure. Director General Uganda AIDS Commission, Dr. Nelson Musova, says the prevalence of HIV/AIDS among women is the highest at 70% and the youth at 3%. Musova has said deaths related to HIV/AIDS were 21,000 by 2019 and new infections are at 53,000 cases.
So you have men aged 45 to 49 with 14%, and the men in that age group tend to be, they call them mobile men with money, and they are the ones engaging in transactional sex with the young women in the lower age group. So you can see that is how you're having the HIV transmission at a very high rate between the men of 45 to 49 with the HIV prevalence of 14% having transactional sexual relationships and cross-generational sexual relationships with the young women between 15 and 25, I think.
Police has revealed that they are supposed to get 24 billion shillings from the Ministry of Finance to pay for bills of power supply, but instead they are given 17 billion shillings only. The spokesperson of the police, Fred Enanga, says when the money in the budget is used up, some police stations and barracks go dark. Some police officers have been complaining about power shortages in their stations and barracks, noting that children cannot get access to education or programs on radio and television. Enanga added that they are also supposed to get 18 billion shillings for water, but they always end up getting 11 billion shillings. The Executive Director, National Bureau of Non-Government Organizations, Stephen Okello, has advised NGOs to think of engaging in active politics only if they have been accredited by the Electoral Commission. He reminded the NGOs of Section 44 of the NGO Act. NGOs are not supposed to engage in the political processes like conducting civic education, election monitoring, but not directly engaging in active politics. He said this during the handover of the monitor site motorcycles to 10 pioneer district monitoring committees to strengthen monitoring of the NGO work.
They can engage in political processes like conducting civic education, election monitoring, but they are not supposed to go into politics. So individuals in NGOs should draw the line between becoming partisan and either supporting a political party, fundraising for a political party or a candidate, or anyone standing for an appointive office. And therefore, under Section 44, you are not supposed to cross into that arena unless you are just engaging in a political process and you are credited with the Electoral Commission.
The motorcycle will be used to run around the district to check on what the NGOs are doing, and then we report. We are required to have a quarterly meeting. Actually, for us in Ruhungiri, we got this motorcycle because they found I was conducting quarterly reviews, and every NGO was presenting its report. We are required to manage basic standards of accountability. They are supposed to have their own meeting, show their sources of program, and also we map a trail to see whether they have impact or have no impact.
In other news, citizens of 15 African countries will have to post bonds of up to $15,000 to visit the U.S. according to a new temporary travel rule, which comes into effect 24th December. The six-month pilot project, which targets visit and business visas, will act as a deterrence to those who overstay their visas, according to the U.S. State Department. Outgoing President Donald Trump, who lost a re-election bid earlier this month, made restricting immigration a central part of his four-year term in office. President-elect Joe Biden, Democrat, has pledged to reverse many of the Republican president's immigration policies, but untangling hundreds of changes could take months or years. The visa bond rule targets countries whose nationals had an overstay rate of 10% or higher in 2019 and will now be required to pay a refundable bond of $5,000, $10,000, or $15,000. While those nations at higher rates of overstays, they send relatively few travelers to the U.S. The African countries affected are Angola, Burkina Faso, Chad, Democratic Republic of Congo, Djibouti, Eritrea, the Gambia, Guinea-Bissau, Liberia, Libya, Mauritania, Sudan, Sao Tome and Principe, Cape Verde, Burundi, among others. And that was the news.
XFM News on point.